My name is Gary Ford. I'm serving as the interim pastor for the next 2 months while First Church prepares to receive a new pastor. During that time, we're going to be together, and today we're going to make wonderful music. And I want to welcome you and invite you, if you're new to the church today, if you're visiting, or if you're a regular attender, please fill out the yellow information card that's there, and you can place that so that the ushers pick that up. Afterwards, there will be fellowship time in the space out to the east of this room. We welcome you to join us at that time. There are announcements and opportunities for discipleship throughout the week that are listed in the inserts in your bulletin. Please take the opportunity to avail yourself of that. There also will be prayer list information and those kinds of things as well that can guide your discipleship and your prayer throughout the week. Today is a major music Sunday, and the chancel choir, scholarship students, as so was chancel ringers, and this fine orchestra that's been assembled here will lead us in our worship time this morning. You will find this to be a rich and meaningful expression of the power of faith and the resurrection in your life as we continue the wonderful Easter story today. There is a special offering envelope that's in your bulletin for Music Ministry Sunday. You can enjoy sharing something with that today if you wish, or you can take it home and bring it back another time to support the work that's done here and the wonderful programming that's done through the Music Ministry of First Church. I want to say a special word of thanks to your director of music, Barbara Cow, for the heavy lifting that she's done to assemble all of this and put it together and make this a rich day. You will find it rich. So will you join me then in our call to worship? Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name.
Bless the Lord.
Gives our iniquity. God heals all our diseases.
God redeems our lives from the dead and grants us with steadfast mercy.
God satisfies us with good as long as we live and renews our youth like the eagles.
Bless the Lord, my soul, and praise God's holy name.
Stand as you are able, either physically or in spirit, and join us as we share together.
Thank you.
Join me in this responsive prayer. We come before God with the truth of our lives, trusting in the mercy and the love of our Creator. Let us offer our prayers before God and each other. Compassionate and glorious God,
you hear our cries.
Thank you. statutes of the Lord are trustworthy, making wise the simple. The precepts of the Lord are right, giving joy to the heart. The commands of the Lord are radiant, giving light to the eyes. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The decrees of the Lord are firm, and all of them are righteous.
Thank you.
Listen to my prayer, O God. Do not ignore my plea. Hear me and answer me. My thoughts trouble me, and I am distraught because of what my enemy is saying, because of the threats of the wicked, for they bring down suffering upon me and assail me in their anger. My heart is in anguish within me. The terrors of death have fallen on me. Fear and troubling and trembling have beset me. Horror has overwhelmed me. I said, oh, that I had the wings of a dove. I could fly away and be at rest. I would flee far away and stay in the desert. I would hurry to my place of shelter, far from the tempest and storm. Lord, confuse the wicked. Confound their words, for I see violence and strife in the city. Day and night they prowl upon its walls. Malice and abuses are within it. Destructive forces are at work in the city. Threats and lies never leave its streets. If an enemy were insulting me, I could endure it. If a foe were rising against me, I could hide. But it is you, a man like myself, my companion, my close friend, with whom I once enjoyed sweet fellowship at the house of God as we walked among the worshipers.
Thank you.
shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Thank you.
save me. Evening, morning, and noon, I cry out in distress, and he hears my voice. He rescues me unharmed when the battle is waged against me, even though many oppose me. God, who is enthroned from of old, who does not change, he will hear them and humble them, because they have no fear of God. Cast your cares on the Lord, and he will sustain you. He will never let the righteous be shaken.
Sometimes